Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, WrestleZone would like to welcome you to tonight's live event. Before we begin, please be advised that all WrestleZone stars are professionally trained, so please do not copy or imitate anything you see here tonight. Please also be aware that WrestleZone is proud to provide entertainment suitable for all ages, and we ask that you refrain from using any inappropriate language this evening.
Hello and welcome to the first edition of this pilot of the WrestleZone podcast. I am your host, Billy, and I have been a fan of WrestleZone for 10 years now, our first event being June 2013, Aberdeen Anarchy at the Beach Ballroom. Why am I here? So we're rebooting the WrestleZone podcast, and we're going to speak about upcoming events for WrestleZone, previews, hopefully some reviews in the future, and possibly in the future with some guests as well. So we're going to tell you everything you need to know about the Northeast promotion in WrestleZone Scotland. I can't wait for this. Like I said, I've been a fan of WrestleZone for a long time, first event being 10 years ago, and they used to do a podcast with Scotty Swift and William Sterling, usually were the hosts, and they'd bring in guys like Richard R. Russell and other guests on there. So that's possibly down the pipeline, hopefully, if this goes well, this pilot episode. But I've picked up because I want pretty much Scottish Wrestling Network, which you're watching this on or listening to this on. I want to do more podcasts about feature promotions, and I've been contacting people to possibly do one for a promotion that's close to their hearts. And even though SWN in general cover a lot of Scottish wrestling, try to cover as much as we possibly can or is feasible to do so, there's ones, of course, that are more passion projects than others. And Wrestle has been a company I've seen for 10 years, so it's one I know a lot about, have a little bit of information from and of, because I've been to the shows so often. So this is hopefully part of a wider network of shows, which we'll hopefully see other ones from other parts of the country, other promotions hosted by other people, not just myself. Because, you know, I've done over about 250 episodes of various podcasts on our network now, and I'm fairly certain people will be fed up with my voice. But you're going to hear me speak about WrestleZone in this particular podcast, and I can't wait to speak about it. So, we've got two shows that are coming up back-to-back on Saturday, the 22nd of April, which is what we're going to talk a little bit about Aberdeen Anarchy as well, because we've got some matches announced for that show. And, yeah, there's going to be a lot to speak about. Hopefully, I'm not going to bed here too long, but let's just get into it. On Saturday, April 22nd, it is this event. We've got family-friendly wrestling taking place at the WrestleZone Training Academy. So it's two shows. There's an afternoon show. Doors open 2:30, first bell 3 p.m. Second show is at 6:30. Doors open. Show starts at 7 p.m. So tickets are available at ringsideworld.co.uk. Go check that out now. £10 per ticket per show. So if you want to try and hit both shows on Saturday, it'll cost you £20. Simple as that. There's matches already announced. I'll cover all the ones that have been announced as of recording. So this will be recording on Monday. It's going to hopefully go out on Wednesday. But if everything goes well, I might even put out straight away, so it's as up to date, up to the minute as possible. You can find out more about WrestleZone, of course, on social media. WrestleZone in most places, at WrestleZone on Twitter, Instagram, and on TikTok, Facebook. You can find them in all manner of places. If you can read some of the bits at the bottom here, you can check out WrestleZoneScotland.co.uk. You can go find out more about WrestleZone in general. So I'm going to go through the match card. We're going to speak about it. I'm looking forward to going through this because this is the last stop before Aberdeen Anarchy. So Aberdeen Anarchy is happening on May 13th at the Ainston Community Centre. This is the last stop. This is the last opportunity wrestlers have to get some momentum, maybe even find their place on the Aberdeen Anarchy cards, because there's only three matches announced as of recording, and promises seven matches plus one pre-show. So it's eight matches in total. That's plenty of opportunities, plenty of spots for a wrestler to try and get into the show, because it's going to be one of the biggest shows of WrestleZone's calendar, probably one of the biggest shows of Scottish wrestling calendar as well. Dayton Community Centre is it's a nice spacious venue, and plenty of tickets will be available. But I think saying that, there's only about 20 or so tickets left for Aberdeen Anarchy if you want to get into the show and want to go to see Aberdeen Anarchy and see what's going to happen. So this is your last chance. This is the wrestler's last chance to build some momentum. It's your last show before Aberdeen Anarchy as well. I'm not sure if there's going to be anything Union Square at all, but we've got a couple of weeks until about a month now, less than a month, till Aberdeen Anarchy at Dainston Community Centre. So this is the shot. This is the time. This is the show. So Wrestling Trade Academy has held play matches, play shows in the past as well. They usually do some two night shows, two shows in one day. And big things have happened that have dramatic ramifications for Aberdeen Anarchy. Of course, last year it was Rhys Dawkins calling out Blue Thunder, and that led to their match on the pre-show, which Rhys Dawkins won through nefarious means. So this is not just any show. This is not just a random show. This is an important show for wrestlers to get their momentum and their spot in Aberdeen Anarchy. So there's play matches already announced. There's I think three for the evening, so for the afternoon show, and about four for the evening show. I'm nervous, guys. It's pilot. It's a pilot. So we will say though, with pilot, of course things will tighten up. There'll be things I'll be looking to improve upon if we move forward and do an Aberdeen Anarchy preview and what have you. So don't just hang tight. We'll get there eventually. But we'll do it. We'll be fine. So let's look at the lineup for the afternoon show. In our first match we're covering for the afternoon show for WrestleZone's show at the Training Academy, we've got Chris Archer against Oliver Green. So this is a brand new face in WrestleZone, making his debut only very recently at the Regal Rumble. Oliver Green, he's in his first singles match. Of course, he's done some reffing in the past for WrestleZone. This is his first one-on-one encounter in WrestleZone in general. Chris Archer, of course, missed Regal Rumble due to illness. He's embroiled in a very personal feud with Mickey Vago. Archer, of course, has challenged Vago to a match at Aberdeen Anarchy, which has yet to be replied to. There's been no response or no follow-up yet, but we'll keep an eye on it. You can find out more through the social media channels. So Oliver Green, he had a little bit of a showing in the Regal Rumble. I mean, this guy, I'm already impressed because he's got that tattoo on his armpit. I'm already impressed. I'm sold on Oliver Green. He's also had some encounters recently with Omar Muhammad, training with Omar Muhammad in Mr. WrestleZone. So he's done some in-ring stuff. He's got some in-ring qualities going on. He had a good showing at the Regal Rumble as well before he was eliminated, unfortunately. So there's a lot of upside for Oliver Green. Chris Archer, of course, has been around WrestleZone for a very long time. He pretty much is part of the fabric of WrestleZone. He's former tag team champion, former tri-counties champion as well. What this guy does in the ring is phenomenal. He's a great wrestler. His attitude at the moment, though, since turning on Mickey Vago, has been a bit nonplussed. He's not been Chris Archer, the happy Chris Archer that we know. He's a bit more sullen. He's a bit more just angry at the world. And we don't know why he's like this. We don't know why he's decided that Mickey Vago needed to be struck with a chain at Station Hotel Showdown, which cost Vago the Tri-Counties Championship. We don't know why. He's not giving answers. And Vago's not one to try and fight his former rejected brother. He's wanting to get answers first. And that's all well and good wanting to get answers, but if Archer just wants to fight, then this is going to end up being a fight. So the Outcast has, you could say, his championship credentials are numerous. He's had fights with everyone. He's fought everyone in WrestleZone multiple times. This is a new opponent for him, though, Oliver Green. And this is going to be just an interesting battle because, like I said, we know what Archer can do. He's a great wrestler. He can do high flying. He can ground someone. He can brawl with the best of them. Oliver Green being an unknown quantity in WrestleZone because we've only seen a little bit of him. We've only seen that little bit in Regal Rumble. We know he can move about the ring because he does some refereeing, but we don't know what he can actually do in the ring when he's on his own and he's got no one there beside him. He's got no one to actually fall back on in like a Rumble environment. So it's going to be an interesting match. There's not much more I can really say about it. That's the weirdest thing because there's such an unknown quality in Oliver Green that Chris Archer, of course, will have been probably there when Green has been training. He'll know a little bit more about Oliver Green than most, but Oliver Green will obviously have this back catalogue of footage from Chris Archer. Probably know a little bit about how to maybe work around some bits and pieces and some moves that Archer can do. Of course, Green like I say, did a little bit of training with Omar Mohamed that we've seen online, and Omar has a victory over Chris Archer. So again, that could be something that's been picked the brains and got some information for that as well. So a very interesting match on the Training Academy show, on the afternoon show. Definitely one to, keep an eye on. It's going to be a match that possibly might steal the whole afternoon, maybe even the whole show between the two events. Yeah, why not? Coming up, we've also got a David versus Goliath matchup. This won't be the first time you'll see me speaking about this kind of match in these two events. We've got Tommy Raiden, the young upstart who's had a few matches now in singles action, a couple rumbles here and there. And he's facing the Outfits Murphy. Now, Tommy Raiden, he hasn't had much luck. He hasn't had a lot of wins in the old W column, a lot of ticks there. And he's also faced some big guys. He's faced Dino, of course, Murphy's tag team partner. He's faced Bruiser Brad Evans. He's faced a lot of big guys already, and he's coming up against Murphy. This again, I'm going to speak so much in this episode about momentum, because that's all that the show is going to be about. But if Tommy Raiden can knock off Murphy, then he's going to have a lot of momentum going into Aberdeen Anarchy. I'll speak a bit more about the six person ladder match for the title opportunity in a bit, but this one will be very interesting. We've got Murphy, who's got this new attitude with the return of Ted O'Keefe as well, and it's strengthened the outfit in general. Don't know if Ted will be there. I don't know if Dino will be accompanying Murphy, or Murphy will be left to his own devices to go and batter young Tommy Raiden. But the lightning could strike, and we could see Tommy Raiden pull off an upset in this particular match. Interestingly, though, we've got guys on this show like Connor Molloy, who was a giant killer when he started, when he made his debut, of course, with matches against Crusher Crabe. And now we've got Tommy Raiden, who's aiming to do the same kind of thing, and they're both going to be in that ladder match as well. So it's very interesting to see how Tommy copes, how he manages with one giant individual like Murphy, when on May 13th, he's going to be in the ring with many giant individuals, from Murphy to Dino to William Sterling. So we'll speak about that six man in a little bit, but this is a very interesting contest. Now, here is an interesting match for the afternoon show. We've got Mr. WrestleZone against Rhys Dawkins. Now, we don't know a lot about Mr. WrestleZone. That's abundantly clear. Of course, the big rumor, innuendo, that it's Scotty Swift that's behind the mask was quashed at Regal Rumble, because you put out a video that he was dog-sitting during the show. So we know that Scotty Swift is not Mr. WrestleZone. Clearly, evidence is there, but we don't know who's under that mask. Rhys Dawkins, though, the smartest wrestler on this side of the globe, he seems to think it's Scotty Swift. That seems to be the thought between Rhys Dawkins and also Brian Tucker as well. So we just don't know. This is the mystery. We talked about the mystery in the first match that we spoke about there with Oliver Green, really an unknown quantity. But Mr. WrestleZone, he looked like he had a little bit of experience about him when he made his debut at Regal Rumble. Of course, Rhys Dawkins and Brian Tucker will speak a little bit about Scotty Swift, even though we know Mr. WrestleZone is not Scotty Swift. What we do know is Rhys Dawkins and Brian Tucker, of course, have some unfinished business with Omar Mohamed, all in part because at Christmas Chaos, Scotty Swift's career ended thanks to Brian Tucker pinning Scotty Swift, but because of Rhys Dawkins striking Mr. WrestleZone with a book of Shakespeare, which led to the ultimate downfall of Scotty Swift, which saw Swift, an absolute fan favourite, the John Cena of WrestleZone, having to step away from the ring. Since then, of course, Omar he fought both Dawkins and Tucker at Station Hotel Showdown. Scotty Swift was there as a fan. There was a heated, almost into a brawl. There was some pushing and to and throwing, and Scotty Swift has had to remove himself from future shows, as he can't bear to be at shows because of being unable to actually get in the ring and be a wrestler. So, and then Mr. WrestleZone appeared. So, like I say, the timelines, I can see where Rhys Dawkins is thinking there's a timeline that's kind of that's correlating. But, like I say, the evidence has been put out there. We know it's not Scotty Swift. Scotty Swift is not Mr. WrestleZone. Mr. WrestleZone is not Scotty Swift. It is a completely different animal here. We've seen some training montage, which we're going to show a little bit of in a moment, which had Omar Mohammed and Mr. WrestleZone and Oliver Green doing a little bit of training. What we do know is Omar won't be at the show because he'll be celebrating Eid. I'm hoping I've phrased that correctly, celebrating Eid. So he won't be at the show itself. So Mr. WrestleZone may just be on his own. So let's have a look at that little clip that they've put out on the WrestleZone social media.
April 22nd, WrestleZone Training Academy. Mr. WrestleZone, the main man, goes one-on-one against Rhys Dawkins. And I've been training him, and it's been challenging. But I've got the heebie-jeebies. He's ready.
Are you ready? Mr. Rhys Dawkins, April 22nd at the WrestleZone Training Academy. We go one-on-one. This man right here has been training me. It's been challenging, but we're ready. And let me just say, in addition to what I just said, Mr. Rhys Dawkins, you are a very smart man, but I am also smart.
Are you okay?
I'm great. Are you going to be in my corner, Mr. Omar Mohammed?
No, Mr. WrestleZone, we talked about this. It's Eid that day. You know, Muslims all come together, they have a big feast, it's a big celebration, you know, it's pretty good.
Is that like Christmas? Bruiser by the evidence, kick the false slammer!
No. Save it for Dawkins.
I will save it for Dawkins.
Save it for Dawkins.
You know what, I'm gonna get a little example of what's gonna happen. I've been working on something. Judo chop! Okay. I made a mistake. Big mistake.
So that's the matches announced so far for the afternoon show. Like I say, if you go to the social media or for WrestleZone, you can go find out more and see some more matches. I'm sure will be announced in the coming days before Saturday, the 22nd of April. Remember, you get tickets ringsideworld.co.uk, £10 per show. So if you want to go to just the afternoon show, that's £10. There you go. Sorry. If you want to go to the evening show, £10. If you want to go to both, 20. There you go. Doors open at 2:30 at the WrestleZone Training Academy with the first bell planned for 3 p.m. Even with just those matches announced so far, you're in for a treat. There's going to be some darn good wrestling. So the big thing we may find out a little bit more about Mr. WrestleZone, we might find out a bit more about Oliver Green as they look to mark their way, march way to Aberdeen Anarchy coming up. So they don't currently have matches at the moment. Actually, neither does anyone so far in that, I don't think. Of course, Chris Archer and Oliver Green. Archer has his challenge out for Mickey Vago that is yet to be answered as of recording. So a lot going on there. Doors open 2:30 p.m. Tickets available now at ringsideworld.co.uk. Let's go have a look at the evening show then. And we're back with the evening show lineup. So there's a few more matches announced for the evening show. So hopefully we'll touch on all of them as we go. We'll kick off this particular segment with Alex Webb versus Bruiser Brad Evans. So this is a David versus Goliath matchup. This is Spider-Man against Bonesaw McGraw. This is Spider-Man against Rhino. This is your Spider-Man against Lizard. This is your you get the idea. You got Alex Webb, of course, YouTube sensation, one half of the WrestleZone Tag Team Champions. He'll be coming up against the former Tag Team Champion, Bruiser Brad Evans, as they are looking to build some momentum for their match at Aberdeen Anarchy, which is a 2 out of 3 falls tag team contest. With, of course, the Fair City Saints, Webb and Myles, against Bruiser Brad Evans and Ryan Riley of the Foundation of the Future. These guys have already got a bunch of history just in very short order in WrestleZone itself and across the country as well. Of course, the Fair City Saints, they defeated the Foundation of the Future at Christmas Chaos to win the WrestleZone Tag Team Championships. Webb, of course, made his debut. I said, of course, a lot. I apologize. And so I'll fix that in future episodes. Webb has made his debut at Regal Rumble last year. Summerhill Showdown last year. So he's got a little bit of time in WrestleZone. He's seen the layout of the land. He's had a little bit of singles match against Brian Tucker. So he's had his fill of matches in WrestleZone itself so far, whether it's been singles or tag or in Rumbles. So he's got a little bit of experience, but he's coming against Bruiser Brad Evans, who's a monster. this guy is getting bigger. This guy's getting bigger and broader each show. He's terrifying. He's terrifying. That's pretty much the all you can say about Bruiser Brad Evans. He's a terrifying dude, and he's out there to hurt people. He's out there to throw big forearms and throw bodies and hit a pile driver if he so chooses. He's a big dude, and he's a big scary dude with that as well. Of course, Bruiser Brad and Ryan Riley themselves, we'll get to Ryan Riley's match in a moment. They've got a little bit more experience as tag team competitors more recently, but Brad has been doing some singles action. Of course, he had a match against, it was Damien. He's had matches against Aspen Faith as well, which were hard hitting. Caleb Valhalla as well. He's had a match against Caleb recently as well. So he has thrown the biggest and best around. And he's gone up against Alex Webb, who I say he's had his singles matches, he's had rumbles, but he's probably more tuned to tag team wrestling at the moment, especially in WrestleZone. So there's a lot of factors here. We'll say that. A lot of factors going on that has got to be taken into account in this particular match and the match we're going to speak about next. But it's all about momentum. So even for whatever reason, if Webb gets the win, if Brad has a lot of offense, is able to maybe do a bit of damage to Webb, that could be a factor for Avenue Anarchy as well. So there's a lot of things that could happen in this match that it's all about momentum. It's all about trying to get one up on the other before Avenue Anarchy. At the moment, the Fair City Saints as a unit have one up over Foundation of the Future, but of course by winning and defending the WrestleZone Tag Team Championships that the Foundation so covet. But like I say, anything can happen. Especially the Training Academy, an academy that Brad Evans will know a bit more about. He'll know a bit more of the layout of the actual unit itself, being a trainee from that, a graduate from the academy. A lot will be at play in this particular match. Let's look at the other one involving these two teams. The other half of course, the Fair City Saints and Foundation Future. I'm noticing that, of course, things so often. But we have, of course, Air Miles and Ryan Riley are also competing against each other on the evening show at the Training Academy. One of the most mind-blowing things at Regal Rumble between these two, of course, the two teams faced off. Fair City Saints were able to retain the WrestleZone Tag Team Championships against the Foundation of the Future. The thing that the lasting memory that people have is just the opening moment, which was Air Miles flipping into the ring and Ryan Riley hitting the most monstrous lariat I've ever seen as a wrestling fan to turn Miles inside out, and that he was on the back foot for the majority of the match, therefore leaving Alex Webb doing a lot of the work in the ring, being able to try and hold on to the titles, which they ultimately did. So there's not much more I can really add from the first match, because these two matches are so linked, and again, it's all about momentum. It's all about trying to get one up on the other as we go to Aberdeen Anarchy on May 13th at the Dainston Community Centre. So it's all to play for. If both teams are able to get a victory, then we're kind of an even playing field. If both Foundation members are able to get wins, then they've got the momentum going into Aberdeen Anarchy. If both Myles and Webb do the same, then they've got the advantage. So it's all about advantage, momentum, and hopefully they'll be hoping to either regain or recapture the WrestleZone Tag Team Championship. So a lot at stake in this particular match, not much more I can really add, but the Foundation of the Future did have a little word about this particular upcoming match, along with their match at Avenue Anarchy, which we'll show now.
22nd of April, Brad.
Oh yeah.
Singles matches for the premier tag team in the country. You go one-on-one with Alex Webb, and I go one-on-one with Stephen Air Miles. And we're very familiar with them, Brad. We know them very well.
Very familiar. As you can see, I'm getting my grip all nice and tight for you, Webb. Because when you go jumping up, I've got my chalk ready to catch you.
What happens when you catch him, Brad?
Big slamming!
Big slamming. And Miles, very impressive. You're a big guy, you can flip, you're fast, you can move. But I've already proven, when you go high risk, I take your head clean off your shoulders. This is our stomping ground.
This is ours.
22nd of April. You're stepping into our territory, and boys, you better be ready.
Be ready!
Now, the most recent match announcement that has been made on social media, again, as of recording, was this one. Conor Molloy against Dino. So, at Regal Rumble, Conor Molloy defeated Murphy in the pre-show match, which was, it was a good win, a great win. I mean, Conor Molloy has faced monsters all throughout his time in WrestleZone. I mean, it started with Crusher Crabe. He's defeated the likes of Bruiser Brad Evans and Ryan Riley. He's defeated Murphy now. He's defeated just big guys. So the fact that he's going up against a monster like Dino, it's not something that's intrinsically, is that the word I'm looking for? It's going to scare Conor Molloy. But Dino is another big, scary dude. He's got that lariat. He's got that Dino. It's a rolling forearm. A rolling forearm that he's quite happy just to rolling elbow. God, I'm not having a good time here. And I'm not going to edit out because this is the excitement and I have for this particular show, these shows and matches in this company. So he's got that rolling elbow that he's quite happy just to absolutely murder people with. He's done it to Omar Muhammad, he's done it to Scottie Swift, he's done it to Damien. Anyone who comes into the path with that elbow has not had a good time out of it. They've had to crumple, they've just had to fall. So Conor will have to try and get out of the way and try and use any agility and speed that he can muster and find to try and avoid that elbow. These two, of course, will be in an action at Aberdeen Anarchy in a very interesting match. I'll speak about it now. So a future title opportunity ladder match. So it's six wrestlers will be involved in this particular match. We'll get into, I'll pull the graphic up near the end of the show. We've got Zach Dynamite, we've got Dino, we've got Murphy, we've got Tommy Raiden, Conor Molloy, and we've got William Sterling, which is an absolute mishmash of absolute characters, wrestlers of different styles. It's interesting. It's very interesting. And these two will obviously be needing to look to try and get some sort of momentum. This is what the show's about. Like I say, it's not just a random show before Aberdeen Anarchy. This is the show that needs to happen to get this momentum, to get the opportunities, and to make sure that they have a place at Aberdeen Anarchy at Dainston Community Centre on May 13th. So there's a lot at stake, a lot going on. And if Dino is able to knock down former tag team champion Conor Molloy before Aberdeen Anarchy, then that'll give him a high spirit, so give him a good bit of momentum going into that ladder match at Aberdeen Anarchy. If Conor is able to knock off both members of the outfit in back-to-back shows, then his confidence will be skyrocketing as well and sky high. So it's all about trying to get past their opponent and hopefully as unharmed as possible and get ready for that ladder match at Aberdeen Anarchy. So a lot at stake, even though you wouldn't think so much, but there is a lot at stake in this particular match. And to round out this preview of WrestleZone Training Academy show coming up on April 22nd is this one. It's possibly the biggest match they could possibly have right now in WrestleZone. We've got undisputed WrestleZone champion Aspen Faith teaming with Regal Rumble winner Caleb Valhalla, taking on the current WrestleZone Tri-Counties champion Zach Dynamite with Ronan King, one of the best wrestlers right now. As a 19-year-old, certainly. Possibly in the country, you know? Debatable, but I think he's got a strong reason to believe he is one of the best wrestlers in the country right now. This is going to be incredible. This is a big match. This is a huge match to have so close to Aberdeen Anarchy, where we're seeing both Aspen Faith and Caleb having to get along, be a team, because on May 13th they'll be doing battle over the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship. Because Zach Dynamite is going to be in that ladder match, so he's going to have to be fresh. He's going to have to try and maybe not take as much damage in this particular match when he's against two bruisers like Aspen Faith and Caleb Valhalla. We've got Ronan King, who's got his troubles with Damien right now, which we don't know if a match is being signed for Aberdeen Anarchy. One would think possibly there is a strong chance that we're going to see Ronan King and Damien in some sort of match because of their recent past and recent troubles this year from Station Hotel Showdown and Regal Rumble. So this is huge implications in this particular match. Again, it's all about momentum. This is what this whole show is about. It's about momentum. It's trying to make sure that they've got the upper hand advantage going into their respective matches at Aberdeen Anarchy. Faith and Caleb are one of the super teams. They're big favourites in this particular household. I'm a huge fan of both, huge fan of all guys in this particular match. But seeing Aspen and Caleb as a team will be something just incredible. They're both phenomenal wrestlers. They're both big, bruising dudes. A lot of the WrestleZone roster seem to be just big dudes that are happy to smash folk at will. We've got Zach Dynamite, a good tri-couch champion, former undisputed champion as well. He's got all the tools to be one of the best wrestlers in the world, and he's proving it each show he's on as well. He's got the foundation in the future as backup. We don't know if they'll be involved or even near this match. Of course, they will be on the show itself because they've got their respective matches with the Fair City Saints. So will it be forever the future when we've got Ronan and Zach Dynamite coming up against this super team of Kale Valhalla and Aspen Faith? Caleb, of course, winning the Regal Rumble this year with a great showing. He threw out both members of the tag team foundation in the future, Ryan Riley and Bruiser Brad Evans. So he's got Zach Dynamite probably a little bit better, not only because he's not in an undisputed championship match, but also because Caleb was able to throw out both of his boys in the run-up to the end of the Regal Rumble. Ronan King, of course, was involved in that Final Four. He wasn't in the Final Four because he was dumped out very quickly, almost record-setting time by Damien. And he was involved with getting Damien eliminated. So that's why I'm thinking, possibly, we're going to see a showdown of sorts at Aberdeen Anarchy on May 13th. But we'll soon find out if we check out social media for WrestleZone. It's a humongous match for the evening show. This is one that I'm certainly going to try and find footage of, or at least try and find out everything I can about this particular match, because it's going to be a huge one. It's going to probably blow the roof off the WrestleZone Training Academy itself. So it's definitely one. There's so many great matches that I've discussed and talked about right now that could be like match of the weekend, match of the show, match of the day. This is the one that I'm most intrigued by, because we're going to see if Aspen Faith and Caleb Valhalla can get along. Because if they don't get along and they end up losing, then there's going to be some beef. There's going to be some anger, even more anger coming in to that match in the main event of Aberdeen Anarchy. So, yeah, this is the one. This is the one to keep an eye on if you want to see something going down on the road to Aberdeen Anarchy. And there we have it. It's the preview of WrestleZone Training Academy event coming up on April 22nd. Two shows, as I said before. Doors open 2:30, but first bell 3. Doors open 6:30, first bell 7. Two events. Go to ringsideworld.co.uk and you can get your tickets for either or both shows. It's going to be a fantastic night. I'm sure that lineup itself is promises to be an incredible show up in the Northeast. And like I say, we're on the road to Aberdeen Anarchy now, and we're going to go through the matches that, well, just briefly touch on the matches that have already been announced, because I'm going to hopefully do a preview show if this pilot doesn't bomb. So this has been, we've got some questions coming up. We'll get on in a second, but it's been a great show to cover and to have a look at. If you want to find out more, you can go to WrestleZoneScotland.co.uk. You can also follow them on social media as well. And you can find out more about upcoming shows to your area in the Northeast if you want to find out more about WrestleZone. Aberdeen Anarchy on May 13th at Dainston Community Centre is taking place, and I can't wait. We'll get into a full preview later on, but I can tell you what's been announced so far via the social medias on WrestleZone. It's going to be a huge night for WrestleZone. Of course, it's the second Aberdeen Anarchy back since pandemic, and the shows have just been getting bigger and bigger and better. And Dainston Community Centre is a great venue. It's going to be great. Like I said at the start, very spacious, really great venue for just getting a good seat, getting a good view, and getting a good taste of the action from WrestleZone. And this is, so far, three matches announced so far. This is interesting matches, two title matches, and a future title opportunity at stake as well. So, of course, I mentioned the future title opportunity ladder match earlier on. Zach Dynamite, Dino Murphy, Tommy Raiden, Connor Molloy, and William Starling all duking it out to get a future title shot. Doesn't necessarily say which title, but with Zach Dynamite being there with the Tri-County Championship, of course, I don't think he'll be looking for a shot at that. But there'll be a lot of guys that maybe Dino and Murphy will be looking to get a tag team title match. Maybe there'll be Tommy Raiden that might have his sights set on Tri-Counties. Might be, but I think most of them will have an eye on the actual undisputed WrestleZone championship when it's all said and done, if they're able to capture whatever's hanging above them. I don't know if it's a briefcase, maybe it'll be a contract, maybe it'll just be a massive ring, a brass ring, who knows. So we've got that six-man ladder match. The WrestleZone Tag Team Championships, we've got 2 out of 3 falls, which is Fair City Saints defending, Alex Webb and Air Myles defending their tag team titles against Bruiser Brad Evans and Ryan Riley of the Foundation of the Future, which is going to possibly steal the show. If we're looking into a technical aspect, if we're looking for something that's got a little bit of everything, this could be the match, the one that people will be leaving the show speaking about and going, oh, can't believe that happened in match 2 of this 2 out of 3 falls. So that's definitely one to keep an eye on. And of course, the main event will be the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship. It'll be Aspen Faith defending against Caleb Valhalla, the Regal Rumble winner. I can't wait for this. This is split the household, the Strachan household, because Aspen Faith and Caleb are both two of my favorites. Aspen probably being just a notch above, and my other half is a massive fan of Caleb Valhalla. So this is going to be one that will be, depending on who wins, someone's going to be getting silent treatment either way in the car ride on the way home. So I can't wait for this. So you can still take tickets, are still available. You go to ringsideworld.co.uk, look for Aubrey Anarchy. VIP tickets, I think there's only a few left, there's about 20 left or something like that. You've got to get in, because you promised 8 matches, so 7 matches on the main card, 1 pre-show match, and VIP starts at 5:30. You'll get to meet some of the wrestlers, I'm sure. Get your merch in, get all ready, get all jazzed up. I think Danston do a pretty good spread when it comes to snacks and tuck and all that kind of stuff. There's a big Tesco next door as well if you need to. So there's plenty of good stuff happening coming up at WrestleZone, and especially with Aubrey Anarchy on the horizon. We're on the road to Anarchy. We've been on it for a little bit, but this is proper. We're after the Training Academy show on April 22nd. That's it. That was the last opportunity for these wrestlers to earn themselves a spot. We'll be finding out more about Aubrey Anarchy in the coming weeks, I'm sure. We've got some questions though. Let's go and answer them. Thank you for listening to the WrestleZone podcast, this pilot edition of the show. And I've already noticed some things I'll need to improve upon and try and get out of my system, like saying, of course, so many times. I'm hoping when we do a second one for Aubrey Anarchy, I'll get that out of my system. Or possibly we'll do one that'll round up the results. We'll do a little episode, like 10 minutes or so, speaking about the results of this show we're speaking about, the Training Academy show, taking place on April 22nd. We do have a question in from Colin Bruce. He's asking if Scotty Swift will be at the event. Well, I think after the events of Station Hotel Showdown, when he got into that scuffle with Brian Tucker, fans don't touch the wrestlers, and he's a fan, and he got into a fight with a wrestler. So he won't be at the show. He removed himself. He said he's not wanting to come back because he can't bear to be at the show if he can't actually wrestle himself. So I don't think we'll see Scotty Swift there. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. That's not the answer I'm sure anyone's wanting from this particular segment. But that's it. We've done it. We've previewed WrestleZone at the Training Academy for April 22nd. I think we're doing okay. We've done okay. Hopefully. If you're watching or listening, thank you very much for sticking with this particular episode. You can find out more about WrestleZone on social media at WrestleZone in most places. You can go find out more about them at WrestleZoneScotland.co.uk. Find out about the roster, results, and all that jazz. It's going to be good stuff. I can't wait to do more of these episodes and speak about WrestleZone in depth. We'll get some guests on in the future as well. Hopefully with mostly wrestlers. Well, that's the plan. I'll get some wrestlers on and we'll speak about their upcoming matches or a little bit about their WrestleZone journey so far. We'll do some stuff. I'm sure we'll do some stuff. I might even delve into some archive footage of interviews that we've done in the past, that I've done in the past, and we'll get a little bit of clips in there in the future. Other than that, thank you very much for joining me. I have been Billy Strachan, and I've been your host of the WrestleZone podcast, and have a good time on Saturday, and just enjoy some wrestling.